Messi getting his first start for Inter Miami in League's Cup competition against his first MLS competition, Atlanta United. And boy, Atlanta United felt the wrath of the GOAT. Lionel Messi, 2 goals and an assist in Inter Miami's 4-0 win over Atlanta United. Atlanta, the 100th club team Messi has scored against in his storied career. And for more on the Messi effect in MLS, we welcome in our good friend from the Golazo Network and CBS Sports, Nico Cantor. Nico, 2 goals and an assist in his first start. I mean, that's what they paid for, right?
Yeah, absolutely. He looks like a superhero out there. Messi's making everybody look average and mortal because he's a god walking amongst them. It's incredible what he does, especially the numbers that he delivers. Already in about less than 2 games, he's got 3 goals and an assist. I mean, immediate impact, and he makes everybody else look good around him. I believe it's the first time that Inter Miami in club history have led 3-0 at halftime. And it's no coincidence that it's happened with Messi finally at the club. So everything looks different. The flow of the game, the composure that Inter Miami has, the way that they were really able to dictate the game today and really dominate the ball and defend well. Honestly, I didn't think the impact was going to be that sudden, but it definitely has been immediate for Messi and the rest of Inter Miami.
Well, and let's talk about the rest of Inter Miami, because sometimes the look on their face was like, oh my God, I just assisted on a Messi goal, or oh my God, Messi just assisted on my goal. Robert Taylor, he's having himself the time of his life. 3 goals in 2 games with Messi on the team. He scored off a Messi assist and assisted Messi. How much better is Messi just making life for his teammates right now?
Yeah, I would add Sergio Busquets into that equation. Them two, they're really making Inter Miami look very comfortable, to be honest. They scored that first goal and Atlanta United almost had no response. And it's great to see how two legendary players, the way that they think, the way that they can add dynamism to Inter Miami's game all of a sudden, it's honestly remarkable. Sergio Busquets has so much clarity, despite a couple of mistakes here or there. Look, he even said at the beginning of this week that he wasn't ready for a full 90. But between him and Messi, their understanding, it just elevates everybody's game because they're putting their teammates into scoring positions, they're hitting the right pass into the right space on the right foot so the players can turn into the right direction. There are these small details that maybe to the naked eye, somebody might not realize, but between Messi and Busquets, this is world-class quality that you're suddenly bringing to a pretty average team. They're sitting last in the Eastern Conference in Major League Soccer. And although this specific tournament in which Messi has debuted his first 2 games in isn't a Major League Soccer, it's definitely that sort of level. They played against a Liga MX team and a Major League Soccer team today. But it definitely shows you how much that they can elevate everybody else's game. I mean, Robert Taylor must be on cloud 9. Benjamin Kremaski, who's Miami born and raised from an Argentine family, must be on cloud 9. In a huddle post-goal with Lionel Andres Messi, the greatest footballer of all time, you best believe it's reality and it's happening in America.
By the way, I think you're being generous by calling Inter Miami an average team. They are well below average. As you mentioned, they're last in the MLS table, 12 points out of the last playoff spot right now. But what is a realistic goal? From what we've seen, small sample size, there is time, not a lot of it. Miami's got to get some points on the board, as many as they can in as short of order as they can. But what's a realistic goal for the team in pink for the rest of this season?
So Major League Soccer starts up in about a month or so, and they'll start picking up with these games. There's only 12 games left, and what Inter Miami needs to jump out of last place and into that playoff line. There, you guys animated it perfectly. That cutoff line is 9. Major League Soccer is pretty generous. It's going to have to be near perfection, this run that Inter Miami is going to have to put together. But suddenly, honestly, I'm asking myself the question, did one of the worst teams in Major League Soccer suddenly become one of the best because of the addition of Lionel Messi. It's clearly he has brought up this team, risen from the ashes, and made them into this very scary, fluid, dangerous, creative, dynamic team that we hadn't seen, I would argue, in the entire history of the club. It's a very young club, obviously, only their fourth season in Major League Soccer, but 12 games is not much, and there's not much margin for error. I think there's a clear honeymoon stage right now with Messi and Miami, and it'll probably extend for some time, but it's going to have to be near perfect for Inter Miami to get back into playoffs. And then after that, who knows? But they're definitely going to have to make an epic run in these last 12 games. And in fact, if you're thinking of Inter Miami and Messi lifting a trophy, I would lean closer to U.S. Open Cup, maybe even this League's Cup. But U.S. Open Cup, you got to think about it. It's the domestic tournament that is held in American soccer. It's kind of like a March Madness knockout stage bracket with all of the teams in most semi-pro and professional leagues in the U.S. And we have that on our air. Inter Miami is already in a semifinal. That is just two games away from Messi lifting a trophy and helping Inter Miami lift their first silverware in club history.
Yeah, I want to see Messi playing against a semi-pro team next year in U.S. Open Cup or Charleston Battery or Bethlehem Steel or one of the Orange County, you know, Kickers, stuff like that. One of those teams, that'd be amazing. Nico, thank you for adding some prose to the sentences that Busquets and Messi are already finishing for each other on the field, and we look forward to sharing more Messi moments with you in the future. That's Nico Cantor, ladies and gentlemen. Check him out on the Golazo Network. That's right here on CBS Sports HQ and on the CBS app and on Pluto TV. Streams on Paramount Plus. It is the home of the world's game. We're talking about Morning Footy, where you can see Nico and his cast of friends talking about soccer every morning. The Attacking Third Women's Soccer Show. It's all and more on the Golazo Network. Check it out. You'll like it.